On the more mystical side of things regarding the love and ego, it will be wise to ponder that there is a natural unwritten law that we generally do not know about. But once we know it, we see it everywhere. You cannot completely and fully just take over. So, let's say, those who fear the ideas of an elite trying to depopulate, let's say. If there wasn't any, let's call it, sacred rule, then they would just kill everybody. We're using this now as an analogy. But because there is this one rule, you can only make people comply, even if it means that they will accept their own death without knowing it. So, part of this rule is that when you serve humanity a big lie, at the same time you have to make sure that the truth is obvious. So that eventually, if you need to, you can always say, I didn't force you to look at me. I didn't force you to listen to me. It was your own choice not to look around. Because if you did, you would notice that the truth was everywhere in plain sight. So that is one analogy example of using the elite idea and depopulation idea. It's a very scary idea to show you that there is a law that no one can avoid to follow. And so now you know. We have to make you comply. We have to convince you of something. And just hope that you won't look around and notice the truth. So that you will believe us. So that you will go into a war. Nobody forced you. At the end of the day, the responsibility of anything that you have ever said or done is with you. Now, of course, the only reason that we could ever trick any human being in this way is because we make sure that they grow up without being aware of who they really are and what their responsibility really is and what their gift is. So to say it short, know thy love and ego thoroughly and in depth and it's in all its layers and on every level. Because you are love, given the gift of the ego to come here and experience an individual life. And that is your responsibility, is this ego that you have been given. That is the gift of this life. That is the key to this life for you. Otherwise, you would not experience being individual. So if you know yourself, which means your love and ego, and never stop having your awareness there, then you cannot be fooled into a war. You cannot be easily fooled into anything. Then your sensitivity gets to survive and it gets fine-tuned as you grow up and grow older. instead of getting desensitized and lost and never knowing the truth. Part of that truth being that you are the infinite intelligence itself. You are but a fraction of it, so to say, here. You are love itself, God itself, infinite intelligence itself, the creative force itself. You are love here, being given the gift of ego to have an individual experience of being in this body. It is through the ego that you can enter this body and have an individual experience. That is what the gift of life means to you as a human being. That is what it is. So you can imagine that if you grow up and are not bombarded with all the things that desensitize human beings, but on the contrary, grow up in an environment that supports your sensitivity to not go all out, but to fine-tune your sensitivity by, first of all, at your basis, getting to know from the beginning that you are love and your responsibility here is that gift that you have been given of the ego to be here at all. And that when you die, that ego comes with you. It is your responsibility, that is your one responsibility here, is your ego, to raise and groom that ego from your being awareness of love, being love, being that you are love, then you will raise and groom your ego accordingly. But if you don't know all these things, then none of this happens. Then you just become desensitized, as everyone does. This is what is happening. Now, if you do not become desensitized and your sensitivity becomes fine-tuned instead, you will feel when somebody is lying to you. You will feel when somebody is trying to trick you. You will feel if there is any dishonesty or danger anywhere coming at you. This might be the most obvious secret hidden in plain sight.